Sir?
Thanks, Red. Need anything else? You come see me.
There's Erend. Looks like he's had a few.
Your impatience does not hasten the Tanakh, Nora.
Only our annoyance.
Well, thanks, but I've waited long enough. It's time to go.
Absolutely not. This embassy depends on diligent adherence to... You shall not!
Keep telling yourself that.
Someone approaching! On a machine!
Farrell. Open the gates, please.
Do not let her through that gate. That is a direct order.
Sorry, can't do it.
I'm asking nicely.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, Vara.
Hi, Aaron.
What's happening? I ain't on the usual. Aloy wants something. People
Open
try to stand in her way. It's not gonna work.
Gates.
That's it. Arrest her.
I'd like to see you try.
Supporting fire?
Yeah, I'm locked and loaded.
Hey, Nozar. You stupid bastard. You think you got the authority to keep that door shut in the savior of Meridian's face? What do you think Sun King Avad is gonna do when he hears what you did? Promote you, huh? Let it through, boys. Saving the world.
Forget something back in Meridian?
Look, Varl.
It doesn't matter. Made it just in time. So this tribe that Murad told us about, the Tanakh, we need their permission to go west?
Yeah, well, I figured it'd be nice if they weren't trying to kill me the whole time.
But this embassy hasn't started yet. We're just gonna barge in?
There's no more politics. No more delays.
Oh, well. Now at least you have some backup.
I guess I do. We'll see how it goes.
That is the line between east and west. Cross it and die.
Hold on now. Let's take it easy.
None may walk this valley until our signal sounds. That was our accord with the Karja.
I'm not Karja. I came here on my own to ask for rite of passage.
But they opened the gate for you, did they not? What is the meaning of this violation?
Why send a child? Do they want to parley or not?
The Karja can't be trusted. This is no.
Forget the Karja. This has nothing to do with them. I need to go west to save lives. Maybe even yours.
The only lives you can save are your own. By turning back. Now.
Hold! She's telling the truth about one thing. She's not Karja. She's a Nora from the Savage East. And if she seeks to save lives, should we not listen? Let me speak to her. One last favor for a fellow marshal before he's taken away. A fearless, red-headed Nora. You must be the so-called savior of Meridian.
Just Aloy.
I am unyielding Fashav, once of the Karja High Command, last of the Army of the Setting Sun.
You're Fashav. Avad gave me a message for you, that he waits for you in Meridian, where you belong.
Avad always was polite. Well, now I'm even more curious about you, knowing that you have the confidence of the Sun King. But such an association with the Karja could work against you here. As it often has with me. As you can see. Tensions are high. This embassy is a delicate affair. They're about to return me to the Sundom, a gesture that might help soothe painful grievances. And now you arrive, unheralded.
I'm not here to cause trouble. I just need to go west.
So you say. I might be able to help. But I need to know why. Along with some assurance that I won't regret it.
I've never seen markings like those on a Karja before.
The Karja see ink as decoration. For the Tanakh, it is much more. A litany of deeds. A record of vanquished enemies.
Looks like you've vanquished quite a few.
I've fought my share of battles. But I feel that my life, like my markings, is only half complete. This side shows my martial deeds. Before I die, I'd like to see the other half marked with the laurels of peace.
Are you glad to be going back to Meridian?
Oh, I'll admit that I wouldn't mind sleeping in a feather bed or sipping wine from the southern vineyards. But I have another goal in mind. As someone who knows the Tanakh and the Karja, I'm in a unique position to advocate for both. If Sun King Avad is amenable, my hope is to establish a lasting peace.
The Tanakh don't seem that peaceful.
They're not, as a rule. But these are difficult times. Chief Akaro knows that survival often requires change, even if that change means putting aside centuries of war.
How did you come to be among the Tanakh?
It's quite a story, but not a quick one. Though I suppose neither of us is going anywhere before the embassy begins. Are you sure you want to hear it?
I guess we have time.
Very well. I marched with Sun King Jiran's raiders when they came west, hoping to moderate their worst impulses. I failed, of course. They committed unspeakable atrocities, stirring the Tanakh into action. When the clans overran our forward encampment at Cinnabar Sands, I stayed behind to help the last stragglers evacuate, and was taken prisoner. I didn't make it easy for my captors, mind you. And they paid me back in kind on the journey to their capital. I lost so much blood on the way that I was white as a corpse when they threw me before Chief Akaro. I thought I was dead for sure, so I resorted to desperate measures.
So when you met the Tanakh chief, you did something desperate.
Now, I'd kept my ears open as the Tanakh dragged me along, and I heard mutterings about a kind of trial by combat that they revere. So, when they flung me at Akaro's feet, I demanded this rite, called the Kurut, thinking that by winning I could request a boon, my life or even my freedom. The other Tanakh howled, but Akaro stared them down. And then his gaze fell upon me. Evidently, he appreciated my ingenuity. He allowed me to participate in the Kurut. Little did I know what I was in for.
You said the Kurut is a Tanakh trial by combat.
Yes. But it is no ordinary trial. It doesn't pit men against each other, at least not directly. Instead, the combatants fight machines in a great arena, and only the strongest survive. Believe me, it is no easy thing to stare down a charging machine while hundreds around you scream for blood.
I know more about that than you might think.
Do you? Well, then you have my respect. Like you, I lived through it to claim my prize. I had hoped for freedom, but... well, that wasn't on offer. Only service to the chief.
You wound up serving the Tanakh chief.
The winners of the Kurut must serve the chief as his marshals.
You mentioned that word before. What does it mean?
The word itself refers to a kind of protective spirit from the ancient past. In practice, marshals are Hikaru's roving lawgivers, part magistrate, part judge, part executioner. I won my place among their ranks and served as honor demanded, but many Tanakh still spat on the ground when I walked by. But they did, until I started forcing them to the ground to grind their faces in it.
I guess that's one way to deal with it.
As you may have noticed, violence is the native tongue of the Tanakh. To survive, one must master it. The truth is, though, the Karja speak it too. More than they should. I can't blame the Tanakh for hating them.
So then, are you still Carja?
Part of me, yes. Always. Yet there is much to admire about the Tanakh, especially their chief. I've heard stories about what it was like before his reign. Three clans always at war, constantly slitting each other's throats. Hikaru and the Marshals have crafted a delicate peace. And now he looks to the future. Who knows? Maybe that future will include cooperation with the Carja.
The Carja talk about Hikaru as if he's a monster.
The Carja feel compelled to demonize him if only because he swept them from the field. It is true that he is fearsome. When I was first taken before him, I thought he would flay me alive. But he is no bloodthirsty tyrant like the Mad Sun King was. I think that if you were fortunate enough to meet him, as I was, you would find that he only wants the best for his people. I hope you do speak to him. I'm sure you'd interest him. So, that's my story. You're the first Easterner to hear it, but not the last. The Carja need to know what I have learned.
Yeah. The way you talk about the Tanakh is a lot different than how they do. You asked why I need rite of passage. I'll tell you, but you won't like my answer. 6 months ago, the world almost ended in Meridian. That threat still exists. It's getting worse every day, much worse. Calling down storms, poisoning the water, enraging the machines. The source of it all has gone west, and I'm the only one who can stop it.
I've seen the signs, and I've heard tales of incredible occurrences in Meridian, an army of demons vanquished by a red-haired champion. So I'm inclined to believe you. The burden of your task is written across your face clearer than any mark of mine. I'll grant you this, to serve as proof of your right to travel into Tanakh lands. A task so important, and it's just the two of you. Take it from one who aspires to be a diplomat. Allies are essential. Chief Hikaru knows the West better than anyone. He may be able to help you. He can be intimidating to others, but don't let that deceive you. He is a man of his word.
Maybe. If I need him.
Your choice. You can find him at his palace, past the mountains to the southwest. Tell him I sent you, and he'll listen to
you. Look! The Sky Clan's banner!
Marshals. It wasn't easy, but I brought the Sky Clan with me.
And the commander?
No. I could only convince a few. He isn't yet aware we left.
We have banners from all three clans. If there are fewer from the Sky Clan, it can't be helped.
He's right. Sound the horn.
What's going on?
Not all Tanakh can stomach the idea of parley with the Carja. But enough have come for us to begin.
Then I'll be on my way.
No. The other marshals will not permit it. You wanted safe passage, you have it. After the embassy.
The Carja have opened the gates.
As the sun rises over a land at war, so too can it set over a land at peace. Today is such...
Hear me, marshals! You who claim to be Tanakh!
Regala. Chief Akaro's biggest mistake. A rival whom he should have killed.
You have forgotten that our people were born in blood. The blood of the Karja. Instead, you pledge your spears to a chief who conspires with the enemy. Hikaru has betrayed us. The embassy is proof. And all of you marshals are his accomplices. For this, I condemn you to death.
You'll need more than toothless threats to intimidate us. Exile.
Lancers, form up!
They're riding machines!
Where'd they learn to do that?
Silence.
Vashav! Come with us now, or not at all!
Archers! Light them up!
Get to cover!
Stick to cover! Archers on the ridge!
Stash this.
Here they come!
They're on to us.
Push up!
You need ammo?
We're all mother!
survived worse.
We'll have to get through them.
Skin you both!
Chief, grant me the honor of this challenge.
Granted.
Regenerated. Break that shield!
turn. Come down here and face me!
No! It was an honorable challenge. You've earned your life today. Comrades! Mark this day! Today you have decimated the Marshals! Slaughtered the Karja! So begins our war on Hikaru. Move out!
Get him to the camp. Now.
You gonna make it?
You're going on without me, aren't you? Guess I'm stuck with Erend. For now.
Come on. I'll take you back to the fort.
It's salvage time, boys.
I don't think it can take a hit. I should be able to use it to glide.
Aloy. We're still trying to sort out this mess. Seems like the Tanakh have a civil war in their hands.
That sounds about right. The Marshals weren't expecting Regala to attack.
And the entire Karja delegation was slain. Nozar, Vuadis, Peshav. A massacre. What will you do now?
I have to head west. Hopefully this rite of passage is still good. For what I'm after, I'll cross all of Tanakh territory if I have to.
Then you have a long road ahead of you. This is only the threshold of the Forbidden West. The Tanakh's true domain lies over the mountains that border Plainsong, home of the Utaru tribe.
This isn't Tanakh territory?
All that out there? That's no man's land. It was supposed to be neutral ground. Though, obviously, this Regala ignored that. Her rebels approached from the north, with all those machines they were riding. They must have made camp up that way.
The rebels were riding bristlebacks. And there were bristlebacks in the Daunt.
Are you saying the rebels let them into the Daunt? How would that even be possible?
I don't know. But it's worth looking into.
While you're at it, there were a number of Karja and Osiram who went out there before the gates were shut for the embassy. Maybe you could check in on them. See if they're all right.
I can keep an eye out. Is there a tall neck somewhere nearby?
A tall neck? There's that one, over there, near the Utaru border. But why...
It's hard to explain. It'll help me get the lay of the land.
If you say so. Is there anything else I can tell you before you go?
You said the Tanakh's lands are far to the west. What can I expect to find between here and there?
Well, as I mentioned, you've got a stretch of wilderness known as No Man's Land, and then new Taru farmlands. Past that are the Tanakh, Their territory is split into three clans. Desert, Lowland, and Sky.
Right. I saw their banners at the embassy.
The Desert clan is closest. Ooh, vicious lot. Where everyone else sees an inhospitable wasteland, they see a challenge to dominate. Somewhere beyond the desert is the tribe's capital and the territories of the other two clans.
You don't sound certain.
I've only heard the stories. During the Red Raids, the Karja army tried to push into Tanakh territory, but the United Clans rose up against them, forced them all the way back to the Daunt.
So no one except the Tanakh really know what's beyond the desert.
Maybe the scholars do, back in Meridian. All those scrolls have to be filled with something, right?
You mentioned the Utaru tribe. Their lands are between here and the Tanakh further west?
That's right. Plainsong is their home. They're a peaceful bunch, at least compared to the Tanakh. More taken to farming than fighting.
It's hard to imagine a bunch of farmers surviving in the Forbidden West.
Make no mistake, they have a fierceness all their own. When the Karja were pushed back during the Red Raids, their warriors chased ours through the burning fields of Plainsong. The Sun King has made several overtures of peace to them as well, but so far, they've declined.
If they're so peaceful, why decline?
Don't know. I heard they have their own troubles to deal with. Something about a food shortage. You'd think that'd make them open to trade, but no. They just want to be left alone.
This area is no man's land.
That it is. The Tanakh used to attack anyone past Barren Light on sight, but after Avad overthrew the Mad Sun King, he reached out to the other tribes to offer reconciliation. The Tanakh agreed to a neutral border zone as part of the peace talks. Karja and Asuram have been striking out into the area ever since.
But now, it seems like Regala and her rebel army have moved in.
Well, I'd never call No Man's Land safe, even in the best of times. The ancient ruins of the southwest are a testament to that. Remnants of some forgotten war.
You said there were others who went out when the gates were open before. Like who?
Well, in addition to the salvagers that just went through, there were a couple of other parties of Asuram Delvers. Even saw two Karja scholars trekking southwest with an Asuram crew. Not sure if they're exceptionally brave or just foolhardy.
Fashav called Regala a rival. Someone that Tanakh chief should have killed.
Yeah, I reckon he should have. She's obviously a huge threat. Her attack was coordinated and precise. Until you got in her way, that is.
They knew the lay of the land. And they knew Fashav was going to be handed over at the embassy. If the Tanakh weren't expecting her, she must have spent months gathering an army in secret.
They had to have made camp nearby. Somewhere they could lie low until the perfect moment to strike.
About Fashav.
The man was taken captive by the Tanakh. Survived for years out in the west, only to die just short of the Sundom. It's a cruel end for a good soldier.
There was more he wanted to do. He spoke of advocating for lasting peace between the Karja and Tanakh.
Too late for that now.
What will happen to him?
His body will be carried back to Meridian. As a cousin of the Sun King, he will be accorded official rights and buried with honor. No soldier could ask for more.
It's too bad about Nazar and Wadis.
At least Nazar went down fighting. As for the Sun Priest, well, no one deserves to go out that way. I'll make sure they're given proper funeral rites. It's the least I can do.
Do you think the Karja will take action against Regala? Seems like you'd have common ground with the Tanakh.
An expedition of the Karja army into the west could be taken as the start of another invasion. Sun King Avad won't risk it. That said, we can't allow ourselves to be caught unaware by an attack like that again.
I'd need to be on my way.
Then I wish you luck. The gates will always be open to you should you wish to return. And don't worry about your friends. We'll get them patched up.
I appreciate it.
Sun watch over you, Aloy. I hope you find what you're looking for.
These in my pack. So, this is the Forbidden West. A whole new frontier to explore. The coordinates from the spire should lead to Sirens and Hades. And just maybe a backup of Gaia. It won't be easy out there. The Blight, the storms, Regala's machine riders. But I'll have to push through it all. Find a way to fix the world. Like Elizabeth would. The woman who led the ambush, Regala, had a lot of machines under her command. There's only one other person who has that kind of knowledge. Silence. But what's his angle? Why help to not threaten us? Stash when I need it. Good spot to test the shield ring. Why climb down and I can glide? worked. Well, okay. Guess I can leap off just about any cliff now. Stash later. Must be the salvagers I met in Barrenlight. Looks like something's going on.
Our armor's gotta make all other armors look like rusted buckets of scrap. You really think you can do that?
Roof, come on! You know me. Have I ever given you anything less than perfection?
If it isn't the savior of Meridian, and of my very own operation. Laren, say hello.
Hello, nice to meet you.
You know, if it weren't for this one, I probably wouldn't be standing here right now. Oh, nasty business. What the Tanakh did back at the embassy. But everyone in Barrenlight is thankful you drove them off.
So this is your salvage operation?
You won't find a better place to trade machine parts in the West. And soon we'll be trading in more than just that. For too long, the West has been, well, forbidden. Dangerous. But what if I told you we could make an armor so tough, so infallible, that you'd never have to worry about survival out here again?
I'd be curious to take a look at it.
Of course you would. And that's why I've asked my most talented salvagers to find what they need to make that armor. Each of them will present their work to me. The best protection will go on sale to hunters. Just like you.
Lucky me.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some business to attend to back in Chainscrape. Laren can take care of you while I'm gone. Can't wait to see what you come up with, my boy.
Leave it to me. It'll blow all the others out of the forge.
You have got to help me.
What are you talking about?
The armor. I made a dozen versions of it, but none of them were good enough. And there are other crews further west. If they make better armor than mine, I can kiss that keg full of shards goodbye.
So you get a prize if Carif picks your armor?
A big one. And I finally have the perfect design. I just need the right parts, and fast. So maybe you'd be willing to pick up a contract and get them for me?
What would I be looking for?
Shellwalker containers. Their plating's made to withstand a lot of damage. It'll make the perfect armor. I know it.
I think I can handle that.
Thank the Forge. All right. We scouted out a herd near here. Here's the contract. It'll tell you everything you need to know. You take the machines down, my people will pick up the containers.
I'll give this a closer look later. Thanks.
I'm counting on you, Aloy. Aloy, you managed to get those parts I asked for?
I'm working on it.
Good call.
I might want to read that contract before going on the hunt.
About to get loud. Thank you.
some kind of outpost. With pens. It might be where Regala's keeping her machines. I need to find a way to get in there. I could scan the area to see what I'm up against. And tag any rebels or machines in my focus to keep track of them. Okay, I'm in. I have to clear out this place before I can look around.
Where I saw something. Why did we have to stay behind to guard tame machines? We should be out there fighting.
Someone needs to keep an eye on them. Regala would run us through if we lose any more.
What?
It wasn't our fault. The ground opened up out of nowhere.
Huh. See if she cares for that excuse.
for the stash. Maybe a shotgun against that machine.
The marshals are dead. Soon.
A lot of pens, not that many machines. Where'd they all go? Better check in that cave. A drawbridge. Might be my way across. I can grab this for my stash later. control the bridge. I should take a look. One half of the bridge. How to drop the other side. Scanning the bridge with my focus might show me something. Refreshing, I guess. Looks like there are a couple of weak points. Little ropes attached to the bridge. There. Bridge is down. Machines fell into the tunnel, which must have collapsed as they ran further in. What if Olvin's explosives created the sinkhole? I should head back to Chainscrape to let Javad know. Green channel, Fletcher Price. And the tunnel's blocked. Yep, not going that way. How to get back out. contract before going on the hunt.
So, you've returned from the west. Any luck?
The Bristlebacks were being penned by Tanakh rebels on the other side of the mountains. Ulvan's explosives opened up a sinkhole, dropping them into the tunnels.
Which they followed to the mine and out into the Daunt.
Right. Aside from the rebels, if anyone is to blame for the Bristlebacks, it's Ulfant.
Radiant beams of the sun! And all this time he was pointing the finger at us. Bring Ulfant here. Petra, too.
Summoned like a blasted ale winch. You best be meaning to put pen to parchment. What? Why is she here?
I live here too, Lugnut. So what's this about?
Thanks to the Savior, the sun has shown the truth on the Bristleback incursion. Tanakh rebels were keeping pens of machines on the other side of the mountains. A sinkhole swallowed them, releasing them into the underground tunnels that led east and out into the Daunt.
So it was an accident. But let us not forget that it was the Karja.
I'm not done. The sinkhole only formed due to your unauthorized blasting in the southern mine, Ulfant. You are responsible for the machine rampage, the workers we lost, the destruction the Bristlebacks caused. All of it.
My dear magistrate, has your precious son baked your senses? I would never give such an order without first consulting you.
Evidence says otherwise. Aloy found the shipping manifest in the mine. You skirted the laws of the Sundom, Ulfant. All for a few extra shards.
Greedy as ever. And you almost drowned your other miners and sent that oversized tool over there to intimidate a bunch of refugees.
I demand an official investigation. I won't be the victim of some Karja scheme.
Certainly. We'll conduct a thorough inquest into everything. The Bristlebacks, the mine, the refugees. Every business deal you ever put your name to.
Well, that's not necessary, is it? What if I just return to the claim?
Oh, well, that would save the crown the cost.
Of course. I'll be on my way as soon as I wrap up some previous commitments, tie up some loose ends. After all, the welfare of Chainscrape's people in a transition like
nope,
this...
Nope, you're leaving right now. Chainscrape will be just fine.
You think she can run this scorched-out forged dump? Ha! Knock yourself out.
Get out!
Oh, don't want you, don't need
you! Down with all of
Get off me!
Mud looks good on you, Alvind.
As the sun burns away, Shadow. Mm. Thank you for that, Aloy.
Well, he had it coming.
Here, please accept this token of gratitude. You've done the Sundom and my sanity a great service. And I believe we have some matters to discuss.
Guess we do. Not the most pleasant boots to fill, but I'll wear them. All thanks to you, Flamehair.
Okay. Chainscrape will be better off with Petra in charge.
Like Alvin's gone for good. Never thought I'd see the day.
About time he went crawling back to whatever damp hole he came from.
Hmm. Here, you're the rowdy spark we should be thanking for kicking Alvin out of the forge.
Petra mentioned you were troubled, and trouble's always welcome at my shop. Take a look. Won't find weapons like these anywhere in the Dawn, guaranteed. See you when I see you, Red.
Maybe this guy will fix my lucky hammer by then.
Maybe it'll stop breaking, too.
I've heard of...
your adventures. My armor can help.
Huntress! You're back!
I might want to read that contract before going on the hunt. stash. Ancient wrecks out here. Must have been a huge battle. The old ones. They gave everything they had to slow down the Pharaoh Swarm. To buy Zero Dawn time. Should try using something other than shock ammo. To those machine pens. I should see what they're up to. They've got raiders patrolling the area. Better be careful.
Where are you?
Oh.
Sacred ingredient for someone, I'll bet. I bet I can climb that wall there. Gotta find a way into the camp. This is it. If I want to figure out what's going on here, I need to find whoever's in charge.
Guess we scared them off. You like your false alarms, don't you? I heard that! I need help! Thank you.
I'll get to work.
Give it one more try out there.
I'll find her. Welcome back.
Ammo's out. Thank you. One of these structures is a command center.
Loyal Tanakh, hear me. I was told a soldier from this camp goaded one of the sons of Prometheus into an altercation. You would do well to remember that our allies are responsible for providing the machines that we shall ride to glory. The next fool who interferes with them will be eviscerated and left in the desert for carrion. There will be no second warning.
Will that be sufficient?
Yeah, that should prevent your people from butting heads with mine. You have my thanks, Regala.
May our pact lead to victory.
So Regala's not working alone. These sons of Prometheus gave her the ability to override machines. Of the Daunt. Tracking movement in and out of barren light, with emphasis on the fort's weak points. Looks like they were trying to stock up on blaze. Enough to blow up something big. They're gonna blow up barren light. Make a hole big enough to fit an entire army. So Regala plans on invading the Sundom. At least when she gets an army big enough to do it. I have to get rid of that blaze. I need to blow up that blaze, for Baron Light's sake. This'll keep. Prisoner. Osirom, I think. Hey, I'm here to help. You follow my... I've got to get rid of any blaze that's lying around. Tallmac. If I override it, I can get data on the surrounding area. Don't find green shine too often. I should keep an eye out for more of these rebel camps. Stop him from stirring up trouble. I need to find out more about these sons of Prometheus. Stop them from helping the rebels slaughter their own people. Not to mention the Carja. This pigment would work well on armor. useful, but my stash has room. Sound. The Tallneck must be close by. Overriding it should give me data on the surrounding area. The satellite dish. If I can climb it, I should be able to reach that Tallneck easily enough. This'll be over quick with frost ammo. There has to be a way up this thing. Thank you. too difficult to climb. I'll have to find another way. The machine can swoop down on me. Much better. Shock ammo. convinced her to shoot at me if I break it first. Tribe's home. What's on top of those satellite dishes? Generator. It looks dead. be my stash when I need it. Climb any higher, but looks like this thing can rotate. If I can figure out a way to turn the power back on, I might be able to move things around and find a way up. The dish going. There's the generator. Bet this power cell can get it running. Power's back. I should check that console after. Later.
Impeded.
should be able to get to that tall neck now. Just find the right spot. Looks like I might need to climb onto the tall neck. Just gotta time it right. You look edible, once you're cooked. Everyone all right?
You saved our lives. More importantly, you saved the harvest we carry. The Utaru are in your debt.
Aloy.
I am Dain.
You're saying that's a whole harvest?
The red light you see around you has withered most of our crops. What little we carry, we had to collect at the edge of the plains.
So this is Utaru territory?
It is. Our home Plainsong lies just down the road. I'm afraid you won't see many outlanders like yourself there. My people like to keep to themselves. But if you're lacking weapons or supplies, I know some of them will be willing to trade with you. Here, it's not much, but it's the least I can do to thank you.
I can't take this.
Please, any kindness we see, we also sow.
Thank you.
Dain, you should go. Tell the others we have the harvest, and that we need a healer.
Right. May the land bloom in your steps.
I should go too.
If you do make it to Plainsong, we share our meals up on the northern dish. Dain's one of the cooks there. I'm sure he can make you some rations worth trading for.
I'll try to make my way there if I can. stay and rest, or push on. Positive green shine. light is worse here. If I don't find a Gaia backup, it'll be like this everywhere. That's strange. Those machines don't seem hostile.
I feel like I should know who you are.
Should be able to resupply here. Ah, water in my boots.
Taru are stronger than you.
An outlander in plain song. You'll want to talk to me if you plan on surviving out here.
Keep your guard up if you're heading southwest of plain song. We've had reports of Tanakh rebels in the area. Our scouts are still recovering from their wounds. I'll keep that in mind. Sounds like the Utaru could use some backup against Tanakh rebels.
So I went to the hunting grounds to train.
To improve your next hunt, let's trade.
The blight.
Thank you.
That should help your next hunt.
Aloy, I wanted to thank you again for saving my life out there. I know we don't have much, but I promise my rations will help keep your strength up in the wilds. Hope you know there'll always be a warm meal waiting for you here, Aloy.
Thank you, Dane.
Please! The chorus won't meet with me. I don't know what else to do.
How about you just start by telling me what's wrong?
I'm from Riverhem, to the north. A few days back, I woke to the screams of my neighbors as Tanakh's rebels attacked. They were just scouts, but we barely drove them off. If a full raiding party comes next, we're not fighters. We're done for. I thought the chorus would help us. I thought we all sprouted from the same earth, but it seems an outlander is the only one who even listened to me. Would it be too much to hope that you'd stand with us in this fight?
Regala's rebels, do you know why they're attacking you?
You're asking why the sun sets at night. They are Tanakhs. They live to fight. As usual, among themselves. But this time my village is caught in the middle. The rebels want to strip it of supplies to feed their campaign against the Western clans.
They're not attacking here. Can't you retreat to Plainsong?
An outlander might find it difficult to understand. All Utaru carry seeds that are planted when we pass. My people have planted many seeds in Riverhim's Grove, a gift from the Buried Years.
which I believe Outlanders call the Red Raids. We'll never leave. We sacrificed too much.
You said your own people won't help.
The Khors are supposed to speak for all Utaru, and normally I wouldn't question them, but they see outlying settlements like Riverhem as lost lands, no longer under Plainsong's protection. They won't even meet with me to discuss it.
If I find myself up north, I'll check in on your people.
I ask nothing more. When you reach the village, look for Q. He's heading up our defenses.
Having a good day? I've heard the song of retirement.
The songs bring comfort to those who still live.
Going down.
I've got news, Outlander.
A word of warning. Avoid the ruins northwest of Plainsong. Scouts say something lights up the ruins when night comes. Whatever it is, it's not natural.
Good to know. Something lighting up the ruins. Could be old world tech. Might be worth taking a look.
Let you walk in fields of plenty. Hope you're doing well.
How many people have you sent to complete that work? You can't send people. Not today.
Don't worry on me. I can send it to my stash.
Until next time.
How'd it go in the old one?
Oh!
Machine strike, anyone?
How is she not hurt after such a leap?
Care for a game of strike, Outlander? Let's begin. What'll you do next? I should probably give this a thought. Your turn. You hit armor. Good for me. That's the last we'll see of that piece. All right. This is how it's going to go. What's your answer to that?
Ouch. Okay. I'll admit that was a good move. I'm up. Oh. Guess that piece goes off the board. Can't use that machine anymore.
Let me take a look.
That one's gone. Off you go. Go on. Game's over. You won. Fair and square. Let's start the game then. Your move. I should have expected that. Off you go. I should probably give this some thought. That's the last we'll see of that piece.
Let me take it.
Your move. Oh, guess that piece goes off the board. That one's gone. All right. This is how it's going to go. Overcharging a machine. Risky, but daring. I guess I have to admit defeat. Maybe you'll consider a rematch. Let's see if my machines are stronger than yours. Go on. What's your answer to that? After I went through all the trouble of placing that there. All right. This is how it's going to go. Can't use that machine anymore. A knockback. You know the game well. That's the last we'll see of that piece. Can't use that machine anymore. Oh, guess that piece goes off the board. That one's gone. It'd be crazy if you were to beat me with just one machine. Right? Looks like I put you in a tough spot. Thank you. I'm up. What'll you do next? What'll you do next? I should probably give this a thought. Go on. You win. Like you've done on all my boards. Here. You should have this. I'm here whenever you need a strike partner.
May the wind carry you.